In this video, I'll cover the steps to create a compound curved roof. Using this entryway as an example, let's begin the process from an existing gable roof. This existing entry gable roof has a pitch of about 3.5 in 12. I'm going to make a copy of this roof plane. I will need two unique roof planes. I will curve both of them and I'll show you how to join them. Let's begin the process in our plan view. I'm going to click on the roof plane. I'm going to use the tool called copy and paste hold position. This is going to create two identical roof planes in the same coordinates. I'm going to take one of these roof planes, I'm going to pull it back. As I'm doing that, I'm going to press the tab key. I'm going to move it back exactly 72 inches. I'm going to take the other roof plane and I'm going to snap it so that I now have two roof planes. They have the same pitch. You really can't see any difference in the 3D view. Let's begin with the upper roof plane by double clicking on it. On the general panel, I'm going to begin by locking the top of the ridge height. Down a little further in the dialog is the option to curve the roof. At the ridge, or the high point, I'm going to put in 0 degrees. As I press the tab key at the eave, which would be at the end of that roof plane, it will leave it at 32.5 degrees. Since that's a long decimal, I'm going to go ahead and copy that value and then close the dialog. On the bottom roof plane, I'm going to double click, open it up, lock the ridge, come down, curve the roof, and at the ridge, I'm going to go ahead and paste in the value from the upper roof plane. And then one of the things I typically like to do is to turn off the automatic facet angle and set that at 1 degree. I'll do the same thing on the upper roof plane. So real quickly back into the upper roof plane, I'll come in and remove the automatic and set the facet angle at 1 degree. This is going to give me a very smooth compound curve. You can see in a 3D view that it's looking pretty good. I need to make the exact same edits on the other side. To make it easy, I'm going to delete the roof plane on the right hand side of the entry, and I'm going to use the copy reflect tool to take the two existing roof planes we just edited. This may get a little crazy in a 3D view as I delete this roof plane. I'm going to go ahead and hold my shift key down, click on roof plane number 1, click on roof plane number 2, use the copy tool in my lower edit menu, reflect about, come in, pick up the doorway or the ridge of the roof, and then click to paste those two roof planes. The next thing I need to do is join the roof plane. You'll see in the 3D view that we have a little bit of a problem where the straight roof plane that previously joined had a gable or straight line. In the plan view, I'm going to click on the larger roof plane. I'm just going to pull this back just a little bit so we can kind of see what's going on. You might see a little break apparently that I have in the larger roof plane that was generated. I need to join the upper break to the upper roof plane and the lower segment of the bigger one to the lower roof plane. You see the red selection handle? I'm going to click on that, come down, and there's a tool that is called Join Roof Planes. Number 2 on the keyboard is also a shortcut to this. I'm going to click on this tool and I'm going to come over and I'm going to click on the upper entry roof plane to join that first segment. Then I'm going to do the exact same thing. Click on the lower segment. See the red selection handle? Number 2 on the keyboard for join. Come over and click on the lower roof segment. So you can see I now have a nice smooth joint. Let's repeat that process on the other side. I'm going to pull this one back just a little bit, and on this roof plane, I don't see two joints in here. I do need two unique edges. I'm going to use the break tool to generate an additional edge in here. So I'm going to come down, I'm going to grab the break tool. Doesn't matter really where I click and place this break inside of the roof plane. I just need two unique segments. The upper one is selected. You can tell by the red selection handle. Number 2 on the keyboard. I'm going to come down, click on the join tool for the upper roof plane. Repeat the same process, click on this edge, number 2 on the keyboard, click on the lower roof plane, and you can see that we now have a nice smooth curve. Over in a 3D view, I'll use the eyedropper tool, copy the roof material, and apply onto the entryway roof planes. I'll adjust the sunlight so we can see the rendering a little bit better, and now you can see that the curved S-shaped compound curve entryway has been created by curving each of the roof panels, copying the values for the curvature, and then joining it into the larger roof plane. That wraps up this video on compound roofs. To learn more, please see the built-in help file as well as our other videos. Thanks for watching.